Hello friends, let us learn regarding the social group. Social group is an important short note for all of you, so you must know it very well. So what is social group? Social group is defined as a group where two or more people are in connection with each other. They have a common interest or common goal to share. So group, when two or more people who have one or more goals in common and share common ways of thinking and behaving. Okay, so example is you have group of friends, group of family members, etc. The features are they are in regular contact with one another. In your family or your friends also, you are in contact with one another. They share some ways of thinking. They share same ways of thinking, behaving and feeling. So in family also, you have same ways of thinking, same ways of feeling. In your friends also, you have same ways of thinking and feelings. They take one another's behavior into account. So your friends also, you account, I mean, what they feel or what they think, you do consider. They have one or more interests or goal in common. Fine. So the group plays an important part in people's lives. So to shape the personality, group plays an important role. In the family only, your personality is shaped. Fine. So it is one group. So in that group, the group plays an important role in people's life. In one's life, if a group of friends is good, the all friends or all group members will be developed. If the group of friends is not that good at that time, all friends will be won't do well. Fine. So the group ranges in size as well as in formality. Groups draws line around themselves, creating insiders and outsider boundaries. These boundaries can change over time. Okay. So if you have a group of your friends, you always have a demarcated boundary that someone will be your friend, someone will not be your friend. In this sense, in the group of four, fifth member, you might allow, you might not allow, depending upon if you are sharing the notes with him or her, you will always allow. Fine. Same way in the family, if a close-knit family of a nuclear family, when a son marries, when daughter-in-law enters in a family, the boundary of the group is changing. Now, social categories aggregate. So the difference between categories, aggregates and groups is, groups are sometimes mistaken with social categories and aggregates. Categories means what? People who share a social characteristics. Example, high school seniors of women. Now in your class, BPTH, third year, you have a group with your seniors or your juniors from Tereda College. It will be a aggregate. Sorry, it will be a category. Okay, then all women in a queue makes a category. Okay, women and male. Fine. Social aggregates means what? People who happen to be at the same place at the same time. Okay, example, the people who are standing in a queue for go to a movie. People who are in a queue in airport. It is aggregate. It is just a cluster of people. I mean, people who happen to be at the same place at same time is aggregate. Okay, categories means people who share a social characteristics, means all students from Tereda Nursing College or Dental College or so on and so forth. So the difference between group and society, group is collection of human beings. Society is a system of social relationship. Group is artificial collection. Society is natural growth. Group is members. Membership is voluntary. Society membership is compulsory. Organized structure. Group is an organized structure. Society may be an unorganized structure. Group has a specific purpose. Society usually has a general purpose. Okay. In the group, cooperation is at the heart of the group. I mean, the group stands on cooperation only, give and take. Whereas in a society, cooperation and conflicts, both are the requirements of the society. Conflicts are also there as well as cooperation is also there. Group may be a temporary, society is a permanent feature. I mean, where you stay is your society. It is a permanent feature. Difference between a community and group. This is the same, not much difference between group and society and group and community. Okay, here like group is artificial collection, community is natural growth. Group is a form with some specific purpose. Community is a circle of social life. Then group is temporary, a community is permanent, group is part of community, a community is a whole comprising of many groups. Yes, important difference. Group is a part of a community, whereas community forms from different groups. So community has got many groups. Then the then there is something known as primary group as well as a secondary group. Primary group is a first used by the symbolic interactionist Charles Cooley. A primary group is made up of people who are emotionally close, know each other well, and seek each other's company. So the people who are emotionally close, they know each other very well and seek each other's company. Example is your family. In your family, you know your family members very well. You are emotionally attached with each other. People in this group have primary relationship that are intimate, caring, and full of feeling. Your parents care for you. You fulfill the dreams of your parents. So the people in this group have primary relationships. Primary groups are important in socialization. People participate throughout their life. So in this group, people participate throughout their life. So in your family, you are there for all the time, permanently. Fine, and it is important for socialization. For a function, you go as a family. Okay, so it is very important. Then how do they develop? There are several factors that are preferable for the development of primary group. Okay, it is a small group. It is hard to develop close personal relationship in large group. So primary group is bound to be a small group. Small groups are needed to get to know people very well. There has to be face-to-face contact. Okay, it allows people to communicate with non-verbal communication. Okay, in a family also, if your parents are angry with you, you will able to make out by their facial expressions. Continuous contact. People need to meet on a regular basis to develop a primary relationship. Proper social environment. The environment where the interaction takes place needs to be suitable to the relationship. In this sense, if you want to develop a strong bond, you have to meet face to face. You have to meet on a regular basis, and there has to be a proper social environment where the interaction takes place. Okay. Then the elements of this group are physical proximity, small in size, stable, similarity of background, and limited self-interest. In family, you cannot always think about yourself only. So limited self-interest. You have to think about other family members as well. You have a similar background. You're family is a stable family. You have a small family size and you stay together under one roof. So there are three important functions of this group. First and foremost, is very important, is emotional support. Strong support ties keep you going in difficult times. So your personality shape up in the family. Because in your family, you have a strong emotional support. from your family members. If you flunk in the exams also, your family keeps you going. They boost up your confidence. Then socialization. Family teaches children and later adults how to participate in social life as well as norms and values. So there is a certain values or set of values which we follow when we go in any function or when we socialize. Then encourage conformity. Apply pressure to conform to their norms and values. So what happens in a family? Our parents make us learn some values and they pressurize their children to follow those norms and values. Okay, so deviation from that, those norms and those values of your family are not allowed. Fine. So encourage conformity, whatever is taught to you in your family. Applied health aspect, acquiring and shaping of life. In family, you shape up of your life. Okay, in your family, because of encouragement of your family, you become someone in adult life. Personality development. You become smart, confident, independent because of your family value and because of the encouragement you receive in your family. Then provision of stimulus of development. For development, you get all encouraged from your family. Support and rehab of primary group. You always get support no matter how bad you behave, no matter if you flunk in your exams, no matter if you get certain failures in your exam, your family always support you. You can always bank upon your family. So help society for maintain the social integrity. Family helps society to maintain the social integrity. Then also we have something known as secondary groups. What does it mean? It means the people who share only part of their lives while focusing on a goal or a task. Example is your office or your college, where you share only part of your lives. You don't stay with your batchmates. You don't stay with your colleagues, but you share a part of your life to achieve a goal or a task. These impersonal relationships, yes, in 45 students group, you don't know each and everyone personally. Yes, impersonal relationships you have. Yes, my batchmate, that's it. So, which exist only to accomplish a specific purpose to pass out the exams. Members of these groups interact involving only part of their personality. You always put your best foot forward. You get angry, but you don't show. You are lazy, but you don't show. Fine. So, members of this group interact involving only a part of your personality. Actually, you must be a lazy guy, but in the group, you don't show that. Actually, you must be an arrogant guy, might be, but in the group, you don't show that. In the group, you are always polite with others as per the social norms or the values inculcated to you by your family. So, originally, you or personally, you might be lethargic, you might be lazy, you might be arrogant, but in society, in this secondary group, you are a polite, active, efficient person because that part of your personality you are showing in. The secondary relationships are impersonal, involving only part of the personality. Example is employer, workers, close customers, etc. What are they like? Members of these groups may be friends, but the relationship exists to accomplish a task. Okay, you might become friends with your batchmate, with your colleagues, but your relationship exists to accomplish a task, a given task, that's it. So you are acquaintances in the office. It doesn't look to create a friendship. If a friendship becomes more important than the task, then the group becomes ineffective. इफ योर टीम लीडर बिकम्स फ्रेंडली विथ यू देन यू माइट नॉट लिसन टू हिम और हर. सो इन दैट टाइम द ग्रुप बिकम्स इन इफेक्टिव. सो इन द सेकेंडरी ग्रुप हायरार्की हैज टू बी मेंटेन टू अकम्प्लिश द गोल. ओके, सो वेयर फ्रेंडशिप इज लीस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट, वेयर द टीम मेंबर्स और द टीम प्लेयर्स और कलीग्स आर इम्पोर्टेंट. सो यू आर एक्वेंटेंसेस सोपती बट यू आर नॉट फ्रेंड्स. देर आर सम केसेस वेयर देर इज अ क्रॉस ओवर बिटवीन प्राइमरी एज वेल एज अ सेकेंडरी ग्रुप, मीन्स फैमिली मेंबर्स वर्किंग इन सेम ऑफिस और सिबलिंग्स वर्किंग इन द ऑफिस इन अ कॉलेज ऑल्सो. फ्रेंड्स हु वर्क एट सेम प्लेस और बेस्ट फ्रेंड हु गॉट अ जॉब इन सेम ऑफिस. सो द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ दिस ग्रुप इज फॉर्मल इन स्ट्रक्चर, फॉर्मल रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस, स्टेबल ग्रुप, रिलेशनशिप इज ऑल्सो फॉर्मल, साइज इज बिग साइज, ऑप्शन ऑफ मेंबरशिप यस, एक्टिव एंड इनएक्टिव मेंबर्स. इन योर ऑफिस इन योर क्लास ऑल्सो सम मेंबर्स आर एक्टिव प्रोएक्टिव, रेस्ट आर जस्ट इनएक्टिव मेडियोकर मेंबर्स. ओके, हु गेट द नोट्स वेरी इजिली पैसिवली एंड सम मेंबर्स डू राइट एंड मेक द नोट्स एंड शेयर द नोट्स विद द फ्रेंड्स. ओके, गोल ओरिएंटेड. सो एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस ग्रुप इज इट इज एफिशिएंट, वेयर यू गेट लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू डेवलप एंड योर आउटलुक बिकम वाइडर. इन द सेंस यू बिकम मोर वाइज, यू गेट मोर एक्सपीरियंस एंड योर outlook become wider. Disadvantages is social problems and health problems. So because of this social group, because of this secondary social group, you might leave your house, you might reside in a hostel. So at that time there might be social problem of adjustment because you are away from your primary group of family. Okay, you might get health problems because of stress to achieve the goal or to accomplish the target, you might become stressful and health problem might start. So it is a disadvantages of the secondary group. Now the difference between these two groups are primary group is always small, there is always close cooperation, it is informal structure, it is intimate and personal relationship is seen. In your family, it is a small group. There is always cooperation between your family members. It is informal structure and it is it is intimate and personal relations. Whereas in the secondary group, it is a large group. There is indirect cooperation, means your pune work for the boss, but he doesn't work directly, but he does a lot of work, your pune. So that it will be helpful to all bosses. So it is in direct cooperation. Formal structure and set rules. You go to your office and you leave your office at a certain time. So there is a formal structure. There is a hierarchy which you maintain. So it is indirect or superficial relationships. So that is difference between a primary and a secondary group. That is all regarding groups. If the short note on groups, social groups is asked, you have to write regarding what is a group, then what are the types of the groups, difference between group and society, group and community, types of group, what is the meaning of primary group, what is advantages and disadvantages of this group and elements of this group. So primary as well as the secondary group and applied health aspect important because you are dealing with health. Okay, so applied health aspect, secondary group, elements of the group, advantages as well as disadvantages, and last but very important is the difference between these groups. That is all regarding the social groups. If at all it is asked as a short note, you must write these all things. Thank you for patient listening and have a good day. Thank you very much.